everybody hear me? Do I really need a microphone?
Yes.
Turn it up. Better. I want to make a few acknowledgments of some of the people that are here tonight during this evening with us. I'd like to acknowledge our mayor who just made it, Chris Morrison. Thank you for coming. Chief of Police in Tamaqua, Rick Weaver. Second Assistant Chief, Fire Chief Mark Bauer. From the Citizens Fire Company, John Albert. Captain of the Hometown Fire Police, Merrill Wortman. Captain of the West Penn Fire Police, Richard Weaver. And Lieutenant Mike Matus. And at this time, I'm going to ask our guest speaker to come up, Ms. June Ong of the Second Vice President of Pennsylvania Fire Police Association.
Do I need this?
No.
I'm going to give it back to you. I dislike feedback. No, not the kind that you give me.
I don't know. You didn't get it yet.
But I'll tell you a little bit about myself first. Some of you may know, if you've ever been to a state meeting, I'm the one that won't shut up. My granddaughter tells me I have no indoor voice. That's why I knew I wouldn't need the microphone. I am the second vice president of the Pennsylvania Fire Police Association. For those of you who are state members, thank you very much. For those of you who don't happen to be state members, join. The way we work it there is that you get elected second vice president. And then when your term expires, you become the first vice president and then the president. So at our next meeting, I'll be elevated to first vice president. I'll be in that position for 2 years, and then I'll be the president for 2 years. If there's ever anything that the state association can help you guys with, please don't hesitate to contact me. Let me see now. My name is June Allman. There's a misprint in the flyer, program. That's no big deal. When my daughter was getting married, her soon-to-be mother-in-law approached me and greeted me and called me, as she usually did, Jane. And I had never bothered to correct her, but I figured since we're going to be family, I said, I'd really like it if you, from this point on, call me June. She said, when did you change your name? Okay. Is there anybody in this room that's under 30? You're not going to get the jokes. It's okay. Just keep them in the back of your mind, and when you ripen, you'll get them. Earlier today, I had the wonderful privilege of attending my own company, housing for a truck at my own company. We're a young company. I run with Hanlico Volunteer Fire Company right outside Allentown, Pennsylvania. It's Hanover Township, Lehigh County. But we're right on the airport, at the edge of the airport campus down there. And in 1986-87, when my husband and I, first he and then I joined that company as fire police, it was largely rural or industrial park. According to what they told us today during their little spiel, we have a landmass of about 5 square miles, 52% of which is airport property, and therefore does not, there's no taxes from the airport. So half of our landmass, we don't get anything from. The airport also has their own fire department. During the first years that I was with the company, they went away. They went home at 11 o'clock at night or whenever the last passenger plane came in. And we were the airport. We covered the airport as well. They now have a full-time paid fire department. We're still volunteers. We have an 1,800 residential population, just about 1,800 people in the township. During the business day, there are 30,000 people in our township because of the industrial park and shopping centers and hotels and whatnot. But only 1,800 people live there. We have a roster of 43. We have 13 fire police. There are only 3 members of my fire company that live in the municipality that we serve. The rest of us live in outlying areas, and we prefer to volunteer there. That was what I did earlier today. I was hoping my husband would come along. He found something else to do, which is fine with me. My husband was the captain of the fire police for 19 years. When we first joined, we agreed that we would not both be, and there was room for advancement for me. There was, you know, there was a possibility that I could have been an officer. But the fact that he got to be lieutenant for 2 years and then captain for 19 years, and by the time we were a little way into that, I realized that he would die or retire before I got a promotion. So I became an instructor, and he's got to listen to me anyway. So that's basically, that's my background. I have been an instructor, state instructor, for 12 years now, since 2003, okay? Not because of 9/11, but after 9/11, they realized they needed more instructors. So I was one of those that was recruited early on. I have been able to parlay that into a retirement income. Okay, so as the job that I've done for the past 30 years goes away, I'm going to keep teaching. And not just the fire for the fire service, but for other things as well. So that's my background. You guys are all fire police, or loved ones of fire police, or you wouldn't be here tonight. So I don't need to tell you what fire police is. I don't need to tell you that about that warm, fuzzy feeling that you get after that really, really bad, or by some people's estimations, really, really good call. Okay, I've been out on the explosion where 5 people die, and it levels 3 buildings. And 36 hours after I responded, I finally got to a real bathroom. Okay, some of us have done that. We had an interstate highway that went through our jurisdiction for about 10 years, and then they built a bypass. We've still got the same amount of traffic, even though they built the bypass. So I've had similar experiences to you people. I've had the latitude to be able to travel all across the Commonwealth and talk to other people, other fire police squads. And the thing that, I have to let you guys know is that it's the same all over. I'm not telling you guys anything new by saying that whatever money comes into the fire department, we're last on the list to get it. I have to tell you though, that every time my fire chief stands up in front of the county fire police association, when we host a meeting, he wells up. You can see the tear in the corner of his eye because he knows how important you guys are to the rest of the fire department. He knows we could not do, his guys could not do this without people like us. I also know that there's been a big push in the last few years for firefighters to get trained in traffic control. Please train them in traffic control. We're still going to have a job. They're not going to take it over. But at least they'll know what the hell we do. Okay. I want to open the floor. Does anybody have... We can play Stump the Fire Police if you want. Does anybody have a question that you've never been able to get an answer to, or something that you want me to reiterate, something that you've all, you know, that thing that's, I know this, I know it, and nobody will believe me. I'll let you know whether you're right or not. Yes. Yes.
Is there any uniform instructions on directing traffic on the street? In other words, when the fire police could be trained in the signal for stop, the signal for go, left, right. But we've never been able to come up with any kind of class for our guys to attend.
So the question is there specific hand signals that we can all be using so that everything is understood?
Yes.
There, what I'm going to tell you, the answer to that is vague. But the answer to that is there are several different ways of directing traffic, all of which are valid. And if the cars are doing what you want them to do, keep doing it. You're being effective. Do you guys know about the update for the basic fire police class? Have you heard about this? Okay, the State Fire Academy has six fire police classes. So it's basic, advanced, communications, legal concepts, non-emergency response, emergency response. Not in necessarily that order. There are six classes. There's also one that was never approved by the State Fire Academy called Review. Okay, I can teach them all. Basic. When just recently, within the past year and a half, 2 years, a committee was formed at the State Fire Academy in Lewistown to start with the basic manual. That's the red book, if you've ever had one with the slides in it, the PowerPoint slides. They took the red book and they redid it. And next weekend at the State Fire Academy, they're having I'm gonna call it a train the trainer. They're insisting it isn't. But it's like I can teach the old one, but until I take this class, I can't teach the new one. Why would I want to teach the old one again? So I'm taking this class next week. So after that point, basic fire police is going to be out of a different manual. There's going to be worksheets in it. There's going to be a section where we got to take you outside and you got to demonstrate how to... I got a list of things and I'll go left-hand turn. and you have to show me how you make, you signal somebody to make a left-hand turn. Okay? So, of a list of things I gotta hit, yeah, maybe, I mean, I gotta take the class first, maybe three or four of that list, and then I'm confident that that individual is proficient in directing traffic. Okay, so there's going to be activities outside where you demonstrate skills. This is something that it depended on what instructor you had, whether they even did this or not. Now it's going to be part of it. You don't pass unless you demonstrate those skills. So it's going to be a little bit more uniform, but until that happens, and I don't even know whether if you took basic fire police and it was the red book after we start teaching the new class, whether that turns into a pumpkin or not. But my suggestion is, of course, I want you all to come to class. My suggestion is get somebody in, whoever your local instructor is, or there are folks through Bucks County or other community colleges that will travel here and do this for you. My ETA, my educational training agency, happens to be Luzerne County Community College. So Luzerne is one of those community colleges that can send their instructors anywhere in the 67 counties. Okay, so if somebody calls me up and says, we want to host, I'll go. I live in Allentown. Oh, well, I live in Bethlehem. But I travel up to Luzerne to teach there. The next class I'm going to be doing is down in Bucks County, not through Bucks County, but in Bucks County, in Sellersville. And I've taught in 23 of the 67 counties throughout the state during my career. So I'll come, I'll train you. Anything that you want me to train you for, that would be fine. Did that give you what you needed?
Yes, yes. I mean, it's just talking on the street. Every single one of them. The problem I see is that if there was a training that could be offered, when, where, how?
I usually, if I find somebody with a military background who has directed traffic military style, I'll usually have them come up and demonstrate. I don't have a military background. Yeah, but I get my point across. So, you know, I'm going to learn a whole lot more after next weekend when I take this new train the trainer. But that's what you should be on your radar. Okay? Does anybody have anything else? Oh, don't make this short. Come on. Nobody has one of those, you know, I always wondered. I can tell funny stories. I can sing. Oh, come on. Nobody has anything else. I drove ambulance for 5 years during my stay at the fire department. Never became an EMT, I was just an ambulance driver. But they gave me all the EMTs that were new and fresh and wet behind the ears, and I kept them from killing people. I had been fire police for 10 years when I started doing that. The most scared I have ever been in my entire life was the first time I had to be out on the interstate highway not wearing a fire police badge. And we're in state police jurisdiction, so I got a state cop out there with me, just the ambulance, just me and my partner, and the car door is open into the slow lane of travel, and I'm holding the guy's head so that the EMT can put the collar around his neck, and I said over my shoulder to the cop, can we get some fire cops out here? And the state cop said, I worked on the Schuylkill Expressway for 10 years. We're not going to get any GD fire police out here. And I mean, I had a big red S on my chest from being fire police. I mean, I could walk down the and part the seas. I'd walk the wrong way on the highway without any kind of fear of being hit by anything. I don't do that anymore. But I never was so scared as that first time that I had to be on the highway without that big red S on my chest. I was only an ambulance driver. I wasn't immune to all the things that we always think we're immune to. Vests. We're all wearing our vests. That's a rhetorical question. I don't want to know the answer. Yes, we're all wearing our vests. Okay, and they're compliant. And they're fastened in the front. They're not flapping open. And our firefighters are wearing them too, aren't they? Very good. Very good. Bulletproof vests keep cops from being too badly injured if they get shot. Orange vests, slime green vests do not keep us from getting hit. They just make us a better target. Okay, I am all for vests. We should all be wearing them. We should be wearing them. In fact, I will tell people that they should, you're driving along the Tonestrom. You want to get to the call. Pull into a parking lot, get out your gear, put on your vest so that when you're at the call and you step out of your vehicle in that emergency area that you're already vested. Okay, don't go searching for the vest when you get there. Don't try to direct traffic before putting it on. It is the most important thing, your safety is the most important thing that we have to look out for out there on the streets. The next thing is the safety of the firefighters. The next thing is the safety of the motorists, pedestrians. This is our job. Stay safe, keep the firefighter safety safe, then the pedestrians and passerbys, and then property. Okay? Get you, you know, make sure you've got those priorities straight. I'm pulling things out of the air. There are some of these things that, some of these events that I go to, and I gotta explain myself. I know I don't have to explain myself to you. So, we all have to make sure that when we're out there on the street, or whether it's a vehicle accident, a building on fire, I don't care, we're on the street, right? That's where we belong. Advanced warning. Know how long it takes vehicles to stop. This is physics. How long it takes a vehicle to stop when it's traveling at a certain miles per hour, a certain speed. What are the road conditions? How far ahead of time do we need to start telling people that they need to prepare for? We all see it on the roadways now with construction crews, road construction and whatnot. You'll see a sign on the side of the road that says, traffic patterns will change. You'll see a sign on the side of the road that says, be prepared to stop. We need to follow that same pattern. It's something that the people on the roadway know how to deal with. You guys have signage?
Yes.
And you use it religiously?
No.
And you use it religiously?
No. She's on.
The first thing, when you're going to be altering the flow of traffic, the very first thing that you should be doing is putting out some kind of an advanced warning device, whether it's a flare. And by the way, I don't like flares. Flares are brush fires waiting to happen. Because we all think, everybody thinks that you can light one and walk away from it. Okay? A flare should never be unattended. So, put out some kind of a warning device. Can you think of a time that a flashing beacon or a traffic cone would not be appropriate to take the place of a flare? Then use a flashing light or a traffic cone. Use flares. There will come a time before I retire, where we will not be able to use flares. The EPA will get us. And the EPA pays a lot of my bills. The EPA will get us. Okay? They're going to tell us it's ruining the environment. They're going to tell us we're getting sick from the fumes. Don't count on those flares being there for more than the next 10 years. They're going to be gone. So find something else to take their place that won't catch stuff on fire. You know, we're not trying to promote more fires for our firefighters to combat. Have I given you a little bit of common sense? Common sense is a very uncommon thing, is it not? Okay. I thank you. Have I eaten up enough time? I thank you all for the invitation to come here. I hope it was worthwhile for you. I enjoyed myself. The food was great. And have a nice rest of your evening. Thank you.
Thank you very much, June. Appreciate it. Very nice. Before we get on with our program, I got a couple of things. Before I get on with the program, I'd like to make a couple announcements. We've got to thank a couple people. One, I'd like to thank the M&I Deli for a great meal. Fabulous. And the other people I'd like to thank would be the Tamaqua Italian Club for letting us have this building. And Jack and Brent, you want to come up? Yeah. I'd like to have Gail Heath come up from the Tamaqua Library. Every year we donate, we give everybody a check, and this year we'd like to give it to the Tamaqua Public Library. A great job they've been doing. Check.
I would just like to, on behalf of the Board of Directors of the Tamaqua Public Library and our staff, thank you very much. Your presentation, your gift to the Tamaqua Public Library will help to sustain our programs, of which we're very proud to be able to run. And we hope to continue to provide information, education, and recreation to everyone who comes through our doors for the community of Tamaqua. Thank you.
again, 1, 2, thank you. Yep.
Next person we'd like to have come up, be Andy. Come on up, buddy. Andy, we got you a little something, buddy.
Andy, give me a camera.
Give me a camera.
Andy, this plaque says with our greatest appreciation, we hereby present Andy Leidenbuch with this award in recognition of his support to the Tamaqua Fire Police Association, October 2015.
Andy, you want to say a couple words?
I'll keep it short because I don't want to say that. But I'm going to hold it up. They're getting back at me, so I might as well do this. Can I get a picture of all of you? This will be my way to say thank you for you guys. So a picture is a thank you photo. So this is really nice. No, this is really nice. Thank you very much.
He's kind of hiding.
I want to get
all
these.
Weapon.
Don't worry.
Yeah. All
right. Thank you. I guess the biggest thing is thank you for this. This is definitely not expected. They do all the work. I just take the pictures. You know what I mean? I guess for the most part, when I go to a fire scene, I always get a picture of them because guess what? They're always there until like 4 or 5 in the morning. I get this anywhere. So, but thank you. I like to see people like donate to me. They know I give them stuff, coffee, and they all know that, hometown. I always take care of them. They know that they're like 8 or 9 hours in the morning, but I post it on Facebook, people give. I'm just one that's giving it away. So the one who gives this stuff, I like to say thank you to. So, and the Salvation Army too, obviously. So thank you everybody. Thanks, I didn't expect that. Thank you.
About one something to our own people, and after many thoughts and committee meetings, we decided to give this present out to our secretary, Ed Sossman.
I hope it's a tape recorder.
Well, it's a secretary, so I can take the phone.
You gave Eddie a briefcase. A nice briefcase. Very nice briefcase. And a pen set.
The pen.
With a very nice case.
Oh my God. He's like Sheldon likes to give his pens a dog like.
And on his briefcase, he has his initials. And on his pen, he has his name on it too.
Oh my God. Wow.
So, Eddie, we'd just like to thank you very much for the great job you're doing as secretary. We appreciate it. 30 years of service.
I'd just like to say thank you all, but I'm not in here 30 years. There's a lot of other members that are here longer than I am, but But it's been an honor and a pleasure. And sometimes out there, in hard times, we have fun too, so. And you gotta make it fun, you know? And we've all done it. Even though it's a little stressful, we try and have a ball anyway. But thank you. Thank you, everyone.
Come on up. You don't have a choice in this.
Why don't you put a vest on?
No vest.
Renee, thank you for putting up with your husband.
And the fire,
please. So thank you very much. That's why we got you this.
Do I have to stand by him? It's that kind of
You can show this off if you look. So they know it's there for a reason. There you go. There you go, ready? On three, ready? One, two, and again, one, two, and again, stay there.
Right behind you. Got it.
I was gonna resign.
He's gonna resign tomorrow.
That's right. I was gonna resign from being.
Tough luck now, but you're stuck.
Yeah.
Oh, fuck. Another 30 years. Give her 29 years.
Our program's about to close. I'd just like to thank everyone. I'd like to thank everyone for coming. And right now we're going to hand out some door prizes. And Jack and Brent are going to hand out door prizes. I'd like to thank Jack and Brent. All the committee guys, all our wives for helping out. It's been greatly appreciated. And enjoy yourself. The bar is open. Have a good time. There's dessert and snacks over there at the table. Just help yourselves. Have a good time. Thank you.
Your team went.
Just call.